Václav Neumann conducting Czech Philharmonic Orchestra with the Polonaise from Rusalka by Antonín Dvořák. Coming up next was Giuseppe Verdi, a nationalist.
The Tobin Center presents John Malkovich in The Music Critic, created by Alexei Igoutsman on October 22nd. Equipped with musical insults, Malkovich slips into the role of the evil critic who believes the classic music to be weary and dreary, while the other great musicians beg to differ and fight back. Tickets and more at TobinCenter.org. This nonprofit message is underwritten by the Tobin Center for the Performing Arts. Hear the music and the music makers themselves every weekday at 1 here on KPAC 88.3 FM. Join Barry Brake for Classical Connections, bringing you the best in classical music from South Texas and around the world, plus interviews and more. Broadcast made possible by the Russell Hill Rogers Fund for the Arts, AAA Auger Plumbing Services, and the San Antonio Master Singers. Listener-supported public radio, 88.3 KPAC, San Antonio's classical oasis.
I'm not sure that nationalist or patriot would be a good description of Giuseppe Verdi, but he was politically active. He was actually elected to an office in 1859 when he served on a provincial council. During this time, he was appointed head of a delegation to meet King Vittorio Emanuele. He supported the Risorgimento movement in Italy, which sought to establish a single United Kingdom. In 1861, he was elected to the Parliament of Piedmont, Sardinia, which became the Parliament of the Kingdom of Italy after that unification finally succeeded. We know him for his music, though, for sure, some of which is a little nationalistic as well. The Sinfonia by Verdi, the Milan Symphony Orchestra with Riccardo Chailly.
Thank you.
Music from Giuseppe Verdi. That was a Sinfonia, Riccardo Chailly and the Milan Symphony Orchestra. Here's a Flute Concerto No. 1 by Antonio Vivaldi, Storm at Sea. Thank you.